to wear a rainbow every day and tell the world that everything's okay. But I'll try to carry off a little darkness on my back till things are brighter. I'm the man in black.
Tom Clancy, and today we're gonna be going Darwin hunting. Yes, yes, I'm sure you're all asking out there, who is Darwin? He is Charles Darwin, the most revolutionary evolutionist of our time. He was one of the smartest people to ever step on the world. He gave America one of the greatest experiments ever to think about. There was like John Scope's trials about evolution. There was all this other stuff that was involved with evolution. Some people think that the legends aren't true, that Charles Darwin is dead. When in fact he's not dead. He is not dead yet. We have found him in his perfect society, in his perfect area. He has been living for 1,000 years. 1,000 years is pretty long. We're gonna go meet Charles Darwin. He lives over in the woods of New Jersey. On our quest to find Darwin, we're gonna discuss about these little plants here. They are developed by natural selection. Some stuff from the internet, some notes. Modification by natural selection. Well, these little things here, they're called blooming blooms. They're blooms. The environment may affect an individual organisms in a population of different ways because better individuals are able to cope. Alright, so to say, if this plant was born in a volcano, it wouldn't be made of plant, it would be made of pop of rock or something, because natural selection. Example, the environments limit the growth of population by increasing the rate of death or decreasing the rate of reproduction. So to say that these blooms, if there were too many of these plants everywhere, like pooping up, just sprouting, sprout, 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 they would stop. They would not have as many of these little blooms right here. These things. Because those are the things that reproduce this plant. If it was put in the volcano, it wouldn't have many, like, the rock formations that reproduce the rock. So, Thomas Mouth. If this plant was in a volcano, I bet it would breathe fire. I love these plants, but if they were in a volcano, I'm positive they'd be made of magma or something. The branches would have magma flowing through them. It would spray out magma everywhere. I have a scientific theory, it's probably not right at all, that magma was put on this earth by an extraterrestrial life form. When the massive volcano will erupt in Yellowstone National Park, we will all be dead. I think that the aliens wanted us to die. Like, aliens are trying to come down from space and kill us with magma. Oh my god! If the aliens ever came down here, we all have to get our guns. I would get a big old gun. I would take a big old gun and I would natural select myself. Oh my god! Into killing one of those aliens and kill us with magma. I'll kill it. I'll kill with my gun. That's right. Alright, let's go find Charles Darwin. Charles Darwin hunt is very, very risky business. If I fall into this lava pit, I don't know what could happen. Be careful. Where is he? Oh my god, there he is. Charles Darwin.
Plants and cereal. But first,
he's a genius. So, Charles Darwin, tell him. How'd you get yourself down here?
I was walking one day and my wife, Mary Eloise, and I found a bag of LSD.
The creatures in this creek will have to adapt because I'm kicking the rocks.
So, Charles Darwin,
I heard about this Beagle tour you went on.
Yes, this is my most famous trip around the world.
Ooh.
I went on a Beagle ship. It was called the Beagle. Big boat. Had sailboats on it. And also, I used that boat as my main headquarters.
For
gathering specimens of the natural kind. To further my theories on evolution. Don't you see? Do you understand?
I understand completely, Mr. Darwin. I see that the sun couldn't create a life form by itself.
What?
He's calling to his brother. Mr. Darwin, let me mention a few names, and then you respond with a scientific answer. Elvis Presley.
Number one American.
That sounds amazing. John Baptiste Lamar.
That guy.
That's right, he was in...
Can't say that about Lamar. He was the first to propose a hypothesis about the species
modification.
Yes.
Theory.
Yes.
Yes. He was a...
Tom Clancy just wants to ask you one question, really quick, about the trip to Galapagos Islands. How'd that come about?
Well, I was always interested in biology. So, this was my opportunity to explore the world and see various exotic species.
Mm-hmm.
So I would venture to far corners of the earth. Every once in a while, I'd go to some island and record my findings.
What was your greatest finding on the Galapagos Island?
I found a flightless cuckoo bird.
What was that? What was the significance about the cuckoo bird?
Well, it showed that my theory of natural selection. You see, the cuckoo bird had no predators. Therefore, it had no reason to fly.
So you're saying that every flying bird has a predator of its own?
Well, not necessarily, but...
So if you could fly, who would be your predator?
Probably the space creatures that put microchips inside of my cereal.
So, Mr. Darwin, I heard that the main area of your theory is survival of the fittest. The hunter must hunt!
Country boy.
I'm gonna get Charles Darwin. The last thing I do. Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm gonna hunt down Charles Darwin, and I'm gonna eat his corpse. Let's go.
It's a messy one.
My God. He's right over there. What do you want, Charles?
He's not coming out. You challenge me too?
I'm the ultimate.
Oh no!
Defender.
Oh, you're gonna get it right now, Charles. You're gonna get it.
I'm gonna fix my crew. Get down, Graham. I'm gonna take you down right now.
Country boy.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Tom Clancy, being you out here. Till next time, I'll see you around.
Lord. Okay.